Home is an idea. Home is defined by nature and the environment. It is our private residence as well as the legacy left to our children. It is our partnerships, relationships, and our community. In today's world, the concept of Mother Nature is rapidly fading. The advent of the Industrial Revolution gave rise to many technological advances in agriculture, warfare, commerce, and the urban sprawl. Over time, this conquering mentality has become embedded in the cultural psyche of civilizations worldwide. In regards to women's rights, this aggressive condition has become a staple of family relations and institutionalized in the fabric of society. The progress of women's equality has therefore progressed in the smallest of steps. Einstein stated, "We can't solve problems by using the same kind of thinking we used when we created them." It is my personal belief that it is not enough for us to merely conceive a solution. The moral imperative of our generation is to set in motion a revision of our most fundamental priorities in order to achieve a more prosperous and sustainable future. The painting Mother of Nature is about the opportunity for change. Inspired by the concept of ecofeminism, I have endeavored to create a new premise for a body of artwork entitled Return of Forever. The concept is based on my hope that mankind can return to a healthy, symbiotic relationship with women and nature. Moreover, the shape of the painting is significant. It is the same as the triangular alchemic icons which represent the classical elements of fire, water, air, and earth. Starting with the girl in the pink burqa, there are two concepts that come to mind: the burqa itself and the fact that she is female. First, the burqa is an incredibly sensitive, allegorical symbol which represents several emotions depending on what culture you are from: independence, humility and respect, or imprisonment, degradation, and isolation. It is a metaphor for the expected roles which have developed for women over time. The other concept is the portrayal of a female. My intention here is to embrace the ideas that women are key to mankind's evolution and that humanity is inherently female. The first point is true in an intrinsic, spiritual sense. The latter issue is a basic scientific fact. On top of the burqa, the number 7 is written in Roman numerals. In the Judeo-Christian faith, this number is a sign of supreme divinity. In this painting, because the number is found on the girl, the holy reference is to the divine feminine. The use of multiple arms is to illustrate the girl as a god and is an apparent nod towards Eastern philosophy. This concept was pulled from the Hindu culture, which depicts their gods with many arms to show the multifaceted nature of their deities. On the girl's arms are symbols of the Om from different Eastern cultures. The Om is a mystical symbol of divinity and self-knowledge. Its most common incarnation is illustrated on the mosque next to the pyramid. The large key represents the enormous opportunity for change which exists for women in today's world. Written on the key is the word Gaia, which represents the theory that all elements of the natural world are part of a singular living organism. The larger context is that all things are interconnected. On her pink burqa, the Arabic word for a call to prayer is written, thus signaling my intent to define the girl as an icon of divinity. The girl in the pink burqa is holding on to several noteworthy objects. The owl is a sign of strategy and wisdom. The tree and the blossom signify our ties with nature, the virtues of biodiversity, and the prosperity found in the divine feminine. On the tree, there is a ladybug, which is a symbol of luck. In one hand, She is holding a scroll which reads, Shibboleth. This is an ancient code word used to identify warring parties. Its use is documented in the Bible and the Torah. They said unto him, Then say Shibboleth. And he said Sibboleth, for he could not frame to pronounce it right. Today, in the English language, the word Shibboleth can be used to distinguish members of a particular group of outsiders. You can probably guess which group the girl in the pink burqa belongs to. In addition, a biblical passage is used on the gray ribbon on the bottom left-hand side of the painting. Proverbs 6:6 is cited and states, Go to the ant, O sluggard, observe her ways and be wise. Hence, the reference is to the ant in the painting and to the deeper message concerning the idea of biodiversity and global sustainability. Wherever there is an ant colony, the soil is nourished and remains rich with nutrients. In contrast, wherever man makes industry, the ground is left toxic and spoiled. It is clear that nature holds many of the answers to humanity's problems. This brings us to the symbol in the hand of the small girl, a symbol in Hebrew which reads to life. The small girl in the painting reflects the passage of our values from one generation to the next, that our own personal beliefs are an inheritance from our family, culture, and society. On the burqa of the small girl, there is a Hindu symbol which stands for guru. She is holding the ribbon which is emerging from the book of life. The alchemic symbols on the book are icons from nature. The large symbol represents the omnipresent spirit of life. This is also known as aether or the quintessence. These are the names of the all-encompassing energy which flows to and from everything in existence. The whale, on which the girl is standing, is a key element in this particular aspect of the painting. The whale represents perceptiveness and rebirth. The water is a symbol for emotional intelligence and the sublime unconscious. The artistic goal of the girl, the ribbon, and the whale is to show the depths to which our traditions and dogmatic rituals are embedded into our consciousness. Femininity is represented in many forms in this painting, both overtly, such as the little girls, and hidden right before our eyes, such as the moon and the water. The female symbol on the pyramid is especially important. The pyramid is a symbol of strength and regeneration. It symbolizes the connection between self and soul. Overall, the painting Mother of Nature is an allegorical art piece which implies both opportunity and caution. The painting is a vehicle for my own personal, intimate beliefs concerning the current state of humanity. It is my hope that this message is received and that my art can be a catalyst for positive change in today's world.